Jesus reading on in your Bible pews? Would you open your Bible to Isaiah 64? I'm hoping that all of you have a Bible at home. And for those of you who don't, I would invite you to take one of these home and bring it back on Sunday. And the reason I invite you to do that is so that our conversation today about this text from Isaiah is one that you'll let inform your rereading of it as we go through the week. Advent is a time when we're asked to open ourselves up to possibility. And one of the ways of exploring that possibility is to let the texts that have served so many people who have gone before us serve us as well. Does everyone have a Bible that would like one? No. If you don't, raise your hand and we'll get you one. I know they're scattered throughout. So this text is written at a time of desperation. You know that Jerusalem was conquered, and the people, the leaders of the community, were taken away and taken to Babylon in exile. And they were in this situation for generations, even longer than they walked in the wilderness. So time was time for people to lose hope, time for people to give up, time for people to think there was no way out. And I'm pretty sure that some of us experienced that similar feeling today. So I would like us to kind of get on this L train with Isaiah and hang on to the strap and go for the ride that he is taking us on. So the text opens, as you can see, with, "Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down. I want you here, God. I don't want you up in your heaven making things work. I want you right here, right now. I need you here, right now. I need to know that you are part of my life. I don't want to have to guess at it. I don't want to have to trust the person next to you saying, oh, you know, God is with us. Well, right now, I don't believe it. So get down here and be with me in this time. Come on down. Be here. Tear open the heavens. Make it happen. Make the mountains shake. Make the nations tremble. Make them pay attention to what is right. You do it, God. I can't. Today, I can't. I need you to do it." Isaiah is desperate. Desperate for God to be right here, right now, to help. So you can feel God's hand upon your shoulder, and you can feel God's arm wrapping you and letting you know you are safe and it's okay. What a way to begin this season of Advent, this season of waiting and hoping, hoping because we know there is more to come. We're not ready to give up. Tear open the heavens and come down here now, God. I don't have time to wait. Get down here. And remembering when God did awesome deeds. Oh, I need those now. And yet, there is an awareness that maybe we haven't done what we're supposed to do, and that's why God turns God's back on us. Even in our time of despair and hopelessness, we still know that God loves us. If we can call God Father, or Mother, or Love, or Loved, then we know there's still some hope, right? Even in our hearts that are afraid. If we can call God by that tender name, it means we trust that God sees us as beloved. We can't always feel it, right? We can't always have that sense of confidence, right? Sometimes we go, oh, I don't know. I'm not sure. How can it be? How can all that's going on around us mean that God loves us? What is this? And every day, as Maureen told the children, God holds us in God's hand and molds us. Molds us to be the people God needs us to be this day. When we're open to that experience. You know, maybe today is the day that God molds you to have a clear voice where you can sing the words and carry the tune and be God's messenger through music. Maybe it's that God has invited you to walk with a friend who needed you. And you could be, you could open your door and welcome them in and give them a place to stay. Maybe you found a way to say no to another thing that you could do. And you know you could do it well. And you know that you might even enjoy it. But you also know that the list of things is awful. And you need a break. Each of us is clay in God's hands. Each of us is a gift to the other. And some days, when we're really good, we're a gift to ourselves. We allow ourselves to be a gift to ourselves. So maybe today, you need God to tear open the heavens and come right down here. We've had texts like that throughout the past few months, right? As we've been reading the story of Moses, we've been reading about how there is this need sometimes for God to be that power that comes down and makes everything right, or at least different. God comes down and changes what needs to be changed. And sometimes, the texts tell us, and sometimes it's the same text like this one, that what we need is God in our own heart, so that we're able to be open to what God calls each of us to do this day. This text is a gift to you. I hope that later today, and sometime tomorrow, and Tuesday, and Wednesday, and
Friday,
and
Saturday.
Nice. You got the weeks down. Excellent. That you will open the book and read this text again and sit with it. You don't have to sit with it for a long time. If you've got a long time, fine. But let's say and sit for a few seconds. Do that. And see whether in that moment, the way you need God to be is tearing open the heavens and getting down here right now. And if you say it that way, God just might show up a little sooner. Or whether it's that you need God to remind you that you are God's beloved. And there's everything in between. Isaiah didn't cover all the bases, but you can. Whatever you need this day and the next day, let Isaiah be here with you. Allow yourself to be the clay, not the potter. Allow yourself to be molded by how you perceive God and how you need God and what you need. Allow yourself to be molded. So that when we get to this day that we're coming to at the end of Advent, when we celebrate the birth of this one who comes to show us how to love God and how to love one another, when we come to that day, we come to it with a fresh way of seeing it and experiencing it and experiencing ourselves. How shall we be molded by God? How shall we be shaped by God? It takes God and it takes us. We've got to be open to God's presence in our lives. Whether God's tearing open the heavens, or God has us in the palm of God's hand to mold us and create us.